the talk about the 5% getting closer to the Southeastern average in terms of salaries. As we are learning in terms of educating ourselves on policy, we keep hearing, well, there's no money. So as we communicate with our own legislators, what are some talking points in terms of where we think that 5% can come from?
Yeah, great question. Great question. Again, there are huge needs, and it all, a lot of this started back years ago when we passed Act 388, where we had a three-legged stool, as Kathy already told you all this, I don't want to read it, three-legged stool of support for public education in our state, and one of the most stable was the property taxes that you pay on your house to support education. There were people who complained about their property taxes going up so much, particularly people on the coast. Mm-hmm. Anybody that could see water, whether it's on a lake, a river, or the ocean, if you could see water, your property taxes were going, whoo, skyrocketing. They got loud, and they got busy, and they hounded the legislators on that to the point where the legislature voted to take off that leg. And instead of a stable source like property tax, none of us in this room, including me, looked at your property tax bill. If you own a house, you got off several hundred dollars off your house taxes that you don't have to pay anymore. They said, we're going to put on 1 cent sales tax that will equalize it. They thought it was going to cover it. It has never covered the difference. And we get deeper and deeper. And your local school districts, that means there's less money coming into that pot that we all share. Now, there are people starting to complain about it. And by the way, they said, oh, but that's not quite fair to the rural areas, so we're going to give each one of y'all, your county, a $2 million. We're going to give each one of your counties $2 million to help you out. Oh, that's fantastic. We'll vote for that, because it was a good deal. The deal's run out. Okay? So the rural folks are complaining, because they can't raise taxes anymore. There's nothing there to tax. And it's also the burden fell on the small business people. Because they, if your school district raises taxes now, house owners don't help. They used to help. It all falls on small business owners. So they're mad. And then you got areas of our state like York and North Charleston and parts of Columbia, Greenville, that are growing like crazy. 1,000 new students a year in Port Mill, one little bitty district. And they're having to build schools like crazy and all these people. And they can't keep up. And they're passing on past taxes. And then the legislature also limited you on how much you could raise your tax. Okay? Now, all that sounds good. And everybody says fix Act 388. How many of you would be happy to increase your house taxes $400, $500, $600?
Public education? Check it out.
Maybe 10% raise your hands.
That's pathetic. You care about education in the state. You and my students paying for it. Mm-hmm.
You're probably spending more than that in your classroom
all right.
in your own pocket.
So, exactly. We all hesitated. I went and paid my taxes on my house this year. And I was saying, I'll be willing to pay them. And I looked at it and I So that is the dilemma the legislature is in right now of fixing that. Probably not going to happen. So there are some other options like internet sales and exemptions. There are other things that we could work on. But I do think we got to realize that there's some savings, like I'm talking about with administrative savings and consolidate, but honestly, it's not enough to cover all what we need to do there. So that's why we need the business community. why we need some folks who say, okay, we're willing to do whatever it takes to make this happen, which could be some increase in revenue. Okay? And so I want you to understand, legislators, they would love to give, y'all know of any of them that would say, no, I don't think teachers need to bank more. They gotta figure out how this is gonna really happen. So I would say, you ask, so where are we gonna get the money from? I think efficiency, where I'm talking about, that. There may be a few programs where we could get ahead of the line, but is it roads? They did finally put on some money to help with that. Is it healthcare benefits? You want your healthcare to go up? You want them to take the money that they put in the budget this year to cover your healthcare raises and use that on your salary? And oh, by the way, state employees, well, I told you, y'all have gotten three raises since 2012, two since I've been in. State employees, zero. They haven't gotten